Well, everyone, it's no longer a secret. I'm wearing a wig, and today the conversation has continued to grow over my hair reveal. Tonight, we get more answers and some tips.
When it comes to my hair, I've tried it all. And Wednesday, I confessed.
I didn't really cut my hair. In fact, my natural hair, in all her glory, is just underneath here.
That was the moment that caught your attention. Some sending messages on social media saying, caught the tail end of this segment, curious to learn more. And then there's this. I had no idea you wore a wig. I look forward to hearing more about black hair. Hold up. I didn't use the term black hair, but leave it to Jenna Shortle to get at the roots.
I was told by a couple friends of mine who are black women who had tried to straighten their hair like that, that it literally burned their scalp. Like, it's extremely dangerous.
Did they use a chemical to straighten their hair?
Adrian?
They may have used a chemical, which is known as a relaxer.
So what is a relaxer?
A relaxer is a chemical that makes your hair, naturally curly hair, straight.
Melissa Taylor runs the Beauty Lounge in North Minneapolis. These days, she sees more women getting away from chemicals that straighten and remove the hair's natural curl pattern. Remember when Michelle Obama rocked her natural hair and the internet went nuts?
We're starting to see in media that more people in commercials have natural hair, more celebrities have natural hair. So slowly but surely, it's creeping into the mainstream.
My mom has really pretty hair.
On national TV, in the kitchen, the hit NBC show, This Is Us, weaves in the topic of black hair. The kitchen is symbolic because it doubles as a salon in black homes.
Okay, I have a question.
Questions as she and many of you try to understand why black women would use chemicals, sometimes painful, to alter the natural texture of their hair. The stars from This Is Us say it best.
Significance of black hair for us is that it's always been said to not be attractive.
From the kitchen to professional salons, Taylor wants everyone to make smart hair choices.
All hair that's taken care of and it's healthy is good hair. I would definitely recommend deep conditioning your hair on a very regular basis. Moisture, moisture, moisture. Right now we're doing something that's called a steam treatment, and we will put a deep conditioner on your hair, and then we'll put you under a steamer, which will help open up your cuticle and put additional moisture into your hair.
And one thing Taylor pointed out, at the end of the day, your hair, Rena's hair, Janice's hair, my hair, and your hair is part of your personal brand. It's a reflection of who you are. A lot of you sent messages saying, please let me know when we're going to do the story with parents and their biracial children. Hopefully we'll tackle that next week.
Well, that'll be certainly a good lesson for people that have been struggling with that very issue. And I think a lot of this speaks to the bigger issue of women in general having to feel to fit in to a way that society has, you know, conditioned us to think that we have to be. So, I mean, it's a problem, I think, for all different kinds of people. Yeah.
And that was one of the questions Jenna asked in our morning meeting. Why would you change your natural hair? For years, society has conditioned black women to think straighter equals prettier, wavy equals better. But now you see these hashtags that say natural hair or natural hair movement. It's women redefining and being comfortable with the hair that grows from their scalp.
Yeah, as you have done as well.
You
used to straighten your hair as well, and you finally...
Oh, that was tragic. Ooh. Well, this is my curiosity about black hair was that one of the questions I had is that you were talking about women being encouraged to straighten their hair because it was seen as prettier, but black men have worn their hair naturally. Was that just wasn't going both ways?
And interesting you should say that. I received a message from a black male today who talked about how back in the day he would put what's called a texturizer in his hair. Our producer's telling us to wrap. So we can continue this conversation online. But he would put a chemical in his hair to make it curly.
Interesting.
Keep the questions coming. Okay. We'll answer them for you.
We'll be right back.